Hi everyone, it's been a while. I hope that you're well. April has not been kind to me. I had norovirus, then I had tonsillitis, which I still have, but I wanted to sit down and film a video for you guys today because I'm feeling a little bit better. And I feel like it's been so long since I sat down in front of a camera. In reality, for you, it's only been about 2 weeks, but I had pre-filmed some stuff before then. So for me, it's been quite a long time. So what I wanted to do today was to do something that harks back to the very beginning of my BookTube channel. The second video that I ever uploaded here in October 2014 was an original tag video that I created called the If You Like This book tag. In that, I pulled some books from my shelves, mostly popular books, and then recommended more obscure books that you might like if you had read those popular books. So that's what I'm doing today. Not everything that I'm comparing to is super popular, but many of them have been popular on BookTube at least. So everything that I mentioned, I'll link in the description box down below. I'm not framing this as a tag video this time around, but if you want to do something similar on your own channel, then please do go ahead. First off, if you have enjoyed Normal People along with the rest of the world by Sally Rooney, then I have a recommendation for you. I personally enjoy Normal People, but much preferred Conversations with Friends. I realize that I am in the minority, but Normal People is a modern day love story, especially relevant, I would say, for those in their early 20s, characters who aren't confident enough in themselves and their relationships to state what they want. And it's frustrating because you know what they want, even though they're not uttering it. So if you like that, I would highly recommend this new book by Nell Stevens called Mrs. Gaskell and Me. In this book, Nell is writing a PhD on writers in the 1800s who went to Rome, and she's mainly focusing on Mrs. Gaskell and a relationship that she had with a man who she met in Rome, and she juxtaposes that with a relationship that she is having with someone in her own life called Max. And I think many parallels can be drawn between this and Normal People, so I highly recommend picking this up if you enjoyed the former. Then we have Ali Smith's Seasonal Quartet. This is the first one, Autumn. There are currently three published. This is a book that she's writing very in the moment. It's a commentary of our current political times, but also mingled with art and Shakespeare. If you have enjoyed the immediacy of these books, then I highly recommend picking up Crudo by Olivia Lang, which is her first novel. She's written a lot of nonfiction. She wrote it, I think, in a 7 week period in 2016 during the summer. It's highly political. It's also about gender and queerness and marriage. And I think if you enjoy Ali Smith, you'll enjoy this too. A book that was shortlisted for the Women's Prize for Fiction a couple of years ago and was very popular at that time was The Improbability of Love by Hannah Rothschild. This was a romance with art at the centre, with a painting that had been lost and found again throughout the centuries, and this painting had a voice within the novel. And if you enjoyed that, it was quite it's quite cheeky, really. I enjoyed it. It was quite fun. Then I think that you would enjoy this book here called The Chameleon by Samuel Fisher. This, in a similar vein, is about a love story, but it is narrated by a book that can become any other type of text. So it goes through life morphing depending on which character it happens to be near, so that it can be picked up by the people it wants to be picked up. And it is also a little bit reminiscent of Orlando by Virginia Woolf. It has a similar sense of humour to the Hannah Rothschild. So I think if you enjoyed that, you'll enjoy this. A book I've been talking a lot about recently on this channel is English Animals by Laura Kay. This is about a woman from Slovakia called Mirka who moves to the UK and ends up working in a country manor and falls in love with the wife of the couple who owns the country manor. And it's all about Englishness and wildness and borders. And I think if you enjoy this, then you will enjoy The Wolf Border by Sarah Hall, which I recently read and loved. This is about a character called Rachel who grew up in the UK but then moved to the States, has lived in Idaho for a long time on a reservation where they're looking after wolves, but she's coming back to the UK now because she's been asked to head up this project to reintroduce wolves into the English countryside. It is again all about politics and wildness and what makes us human. It's feral in many ways, and I really, really enjoyed it. Sarah Hall's writing is very rich. Swimming Home by Deborah Levy was shortlisted for the Man Booker Prize back in 2012. It's about a woman called Kitty who is mysterious and causes a lot of drama at a family villa in France one summer. If that sounds like your kind of thing, then I would recommend this, which is Bitter Orange by Claire Fuller. It's a more recent release about a woman called Frances who is looking back at one summer in her life when she became infatuated with a couple at this stately home called Clara and Peter. She was there to map out the gardens. He was there to do an inventory of this house, and she became obsessed with secrets that she thought that they were hiding. Ghost Wall by Sarah Moss, very beloved on BookTube and rightly so, currently longlisted for the Women's Prize for Fiction. I'll link my review of this book in the description box along with a podcast I did with Sarah as well. This is set in Northumberland. It's about a dysfunctional family who are living on a fake Iron Age settlement with a group of students for the summer. It's really about, I would say, gang mentality and the kind of things we can convince ourselves that are okay if we do them as a group. It's very, very unsettling. I would say it's about all the nastiness bubbling under the surface. And when I read that, it reminded me in tone of this book here, which is How to Breathe Underwater by Julie Oringer. It is a short story collection. And again, it is about what horrible things people can do to each other, and it's deeply unsettling. Actually, I bought a copy of this and sent it to Sarah after I read Ghost Wall because I thought that she would enjoy it, and she did, so don't just take my word for it. It's a very good book. I will link it down below along with everything else. If you enjoyed Sight by Jessie Greengrass, which explores medicine, history of x-ray, what it means to be a mother and a daughter, whether or not you want to have children, I would recommend reading The Argonauts by Maggie Nelson, which is a very experimental piece of nonfiction about the body and gender and transformation. If, like me and many other people, you enjoyed Convenience Store Woman by Siaki Murata, which is translated from the Japanese by Ginny Tapey-Takemori and is an exploration of societal conventions and what it feels like to not fit in, then I would very much recommend another translated book, this time one translated from Norwegian by Kirsti A. Skomsvold. This is The Faster I Walk, The Smaller I Am, which is translated by Kerry A. Pierce. This explores loneliness and a feeling of isolation in a society that values different things to what you personally value. And I think both of these work extremely well together. Oranges Are Not the Only Fruit by Jeanette Winterson is a very autobiographical novel about a young girl called Jeanette who grows up in a household which is very evangelical. Her mother believes that the end of the world is coming and she wants to exorcise the gayness out of Jeanette. If you enjoyed that, then you will enjoy Disobedience by Naomi Alderman, which is about growing up in an Orthodox Jewish community in North London, and it's again about queerness and religion and how those things intersect. It's about a couple called Essie and Ronit who are together when they were teenage girls and then come back together in later life. I say later life, not that much later, maybe 10, 15 years down the line. If you picked up a copy of The Republic of Motherhood last year, this is a chapbook by Liz Berry, a series of poems on new motherhood and that sleepless, terrified feeling that also is punctuated by so much love, then I think you will enjoy this new collection by Niall Campbell, which is called Noctuary, and it's about early fatherhood and is again about feeding and about those sleepless nights. It feels like a nightlight in and of itself. We are nearly there. A book I recommended a few years ago is In the House Upon the Dirt Between the Lake and the Woods by Matt Bell. This is a very experimental, strange novel about a married couple who live very remotely and who desperately want a child. The wife morphs into different creatures. It's heavy on the magical realism. She buries beneath the house and builds rooms filled up with her feelings, and it is completely bizarre. It's a book that is not perfect by any means, and there are areas that I wish had been reined in, and I think it could have been tightened a little bit, but I just love it for the ideas that it explores. And in a similar vein, I really love The Evolutionary Revolution by Lily Huang, which is again about a very, very strange world, very like our own, where humans and animals can morph and fairy tales become part of everyday life in a very rotten way. A few years ago, Stay With Me by Ayobami Adebayo was shortlisted for the Women's Prize for Fiction. This is a book that's set in Nigeria, and it's about a husband and wife who are trying to conceive a child and they can't. So the husband's family decides that the husband should have a second wife. It weaves folklore very beautifully. I find it very unexpected, so well crafted. I did a podcast with Ayobami, which I will link in the description box down below. But I think if you love that, then you will also love The Fisherman by Chigozie Obioma, which was shortlisted for the Man Booker Prize back in 2015. I've done a whole video talking about this, but again, set in Nigeria, about a family where their fate seems to hinge on the folklore and fairy tales that they tell each other. And it's really fascinating. So I'll link my video review in the description box down below if you would like to go and check that out. Finally, if you, like me, were a fan of Ballet Shoes by Noel Stratfield when you were younger, then I have a recommendation for you. Ballet Shoes was first published in 1936, and it is about the early part of the 20th century. It's about three young orphan girls who are adopted into one household and are each deciding what they want to be when they grow up. One of them wants to be a ballet dancer, one of them wants to be an actor, and one of them wants to be a pilot. And I think something that will please that child part of you as an adult, or something you could gift to a child in your life, would be The Restless Girls by Jessie Burton. This is a retelling of the 12 dancing princesses and is all about all the different things the young girls could be when they grow up. It's about possibility, it's about adventure, it is about determination. I don't think that you need to be a child to read this. I adore it. Okay, those are all the books that I wanted to show you today. As I said, they're linked down below if you'd like to go find out more. I hope you guys are well, and I hope to be back with another video very soon. I'm planning to kick this tonsillitis completely out of my body and out of the house because it has very much exceeded its welcome. I will speak to you guys very soon. Lots of bookish love.